The Eastern emperors, they're trying to overcome the schism because the Ottoman armies are everywhere. But popular reaction in the eastern part that we know of the Roman Empire is very strong against a union of the two churches, and therefore any hopes for help that could be coming from the West to help them against the Ottomans. So that's the background. That's when the siege takes place. And until the mid-1700s, the remnants of that conquered society started undergoing what Toynbee calls a mental reorientation, seeing the West no longer as barbarian Franks, but enlightened Europeans, a phrase which is constantly recurring in Quaresi's writings. So Toynbee evaluates this as a most remarkable phenomenon in the intercourse between different civilizations, with origins, he says, both mysterious and interesting. As a phenomenon, it is really interesting to see this. It appears suddenly, it seems, at the same generations among both Russians and Greeks. In the case of the former, in the case of the Russians, there is an enlightened monarch, Peter the Great. He leads the whole thing forward. That's not the case, of course, of the latter, because the latter is a conquered society. So what brings forth this mental reorientation is the fact that Asia Minor was the birthplace where modern Greek civilization, as Toynbee says, was born, evolving out of both its classical Greek constituent and its Greco-Roman culture, a process that he roughly places at about the 8th century AD. The awakening of the conquered East Roman society is accelerated, among others, and Toynbee mentions that, because he says these people live in a land which is full of remnants of a glorious past. B, the great theaters and temples of the classical and Hellenistic times, or churches and buildings of the East Roman period. So that's how we see that something is starting to change in the Near Eastern society, in other words, westernization.